Hello friends, I am Dr. Gaurav. In this video, I will discuss about how to use steam tables. Contents are steam tables, saturated water and steam, temperature based table, saturated water and steam, pressure based table, superheated steam table, supercritical steam table, reference state and reference values. Steam tables. Steam is a vapor form of water and is invisible when pure and dry. It does not obey the laws of perfect gases until it is perfectly dry. Steam is used as working substance in the operation of steam engines and steam turbines. The properties like specific volume, specific enthalpy and specific entropy, each of saturated water as well as steam, which can be wet, dry, superheated and supercritical, vary with the change in pressure and temperature. These properties are required in thermodynamic calculations where steam is used as working medium. It is quite cumbersome to calculate each time the value and relation between various properties. So, these are experimentally determined and presented in the form of tables showing values of each property at saturated water and steam, which can be wet, dry, superheated and supercritical condition with respect to either temperature or pressure. These tables are called steam tables. The values in steam table were carefully determined by observations and calculations first in FPS system, then in MKS units and then into SI units. Due to conversion and rounding of the figures, there is a slight difference in the figure quoted in different books. Steam table consists of following tables. First is saturated water and steam temperature base table. Second is saturated water and steam pressure base table. Third is superheated steam table. Fourth is supercritical steam table. So, first is saturated water and steam temperature base table. It contains values of saturation pressure in bar, specific volume in meter cube per kg, specific enthalpy in kilojoule per kg and specific entropy in kilojoule per kg Kelvin from 0 degree Celsius to 373.15 degree Celsius, which is critical temperature. This is the table 1, which is saturated water and steam temperature based table. Column first is temperature in degree Celsius. Second column, absolute pressure in bar, which is saturation pressure corresponding to given temperature. So this column, second column, gives us the value of saturation pressure in bar corresponding to given temperature. Third column is of specific volume in meter cube per kg. It contains of two parts. First is VF, saturated liquid specific volume. Second is VG, saturated vapor specific volume. Third column is of specific enthalpy in kilojoule per kg. This is fourth column. In this, we are having three parts. First is HF, saturated liquid specific enthalpy, HFG, latent heat of वेपराइजेशन, थर्ड पार्ट इज एचजी सैचुरेटेड वेपर स्पेसिफिक एंथैल्पी, फिफ्थ कॉलम इज ऑफ स्पेसिफिक एंट्रोपी इन किलो जूल पर केजी केल्विन, एसएफ इज सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड स्पेसिफिक एंट्रोपी, एसएफजी इज द स्पेसिफिक एंट्रोपी ड्यूरिंग एवोपरेशन, थर्ड इज एसजी सैचुरेटेड वेपर स्पेसिफिक एंट्रोपी। सो हेयर एफ रिप्रेजेंट सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड, जी रिप्रेजेंट सैचुरेटेड वेपर एंड द लास्ट कॉलम अगेन टेम्परेचर बेस्ड। सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर वन थिंग इन दिस टेबल, सेकेंड कॉलम गिव्स अस द वैल्यू ऑफ सैचुरेशन प्रेशर कोरस्पोंडिंग टू गिवन टेम्परेचर। We have taken an example in which we have to calculate the specific volume, specific enthalpy and specific entropy of steam at temperature 15 degrees Celsius when its dryness fraction, that is X, is 0.8. Note, at temperature of 15 degrees Celsius is given, so we will use table 1, that is temperature table, because first column is of temperature. From steam table at 15 degrees Celsius, this is 15 degrees Celsius, the value of saturation pressure is 0.01704. The value of Vf is 0.001001. Value of Vg is 77.978. Value of Hf is 62.9. Value of Hfg is 2466.1. Value of Hg is 2529.1. Value of Sf is 0.224. Value of Sfg is 8.559. Value of Hg is 8.783. So we have find out these values from table 1. Now as dryness fraction is given having value 0.8. So our steam is in wet region, that is saturated liquid vapor region. So the formula for wet steam in terms of specific volume is V equal to Vf plus X Vf into Vfg. Here X is 0.8. H equal to Hf plus X into Hfg, S equal to Sf plus X Sfg. We can find out the value of Vf, Hf, Sf, Vfg, Hfg, Sfg from the steam table. The value of Vfg is equal to Vg minus Vf, Vg minus Vf. Similarly, the value of HFG is equal to HG minus HF. Value of SFG is equal to SG minus SF. So in this way, we can find out the value of V, H and S for wet steam. When the value of temperature 15 degrees Celsius and pressure 0.01597 bar is given, then from table 1, we find that at 0.01597 bar, the value of saturation temperature is 14 degrees Celsius. As you can see, the pressure, the given saturation pressure is 0.01597. Now, at this pressure, we are having temperature value as 14 degrees Celsius, which is our saturation temperature, which is lesser than 50 degrees Celsius. So you can see this is lesser than 50 degrees Celsius. Therefore, at temperature 15 degrees Celsius and pressure 0.01597 bar, water is in superheated vapor region, that is superheated steam. For superheated steam, we will use below formula And in this formula, find the value of Hg, Sg and Vg at 14 degrees Celsius. This at 14 degrees Celsius. Vg, Hg, Sg. From table 1. And CpV is the specific heat at constant pressure for vapor. So this is the formula of H superheated equal to Hg plus CpV into T superheated minus T saturated. T superheated is 15 degrees Celsius. So convert this into Kelvin. Convert this into Kelvin. Minus T saturated is 14 degrees Celsius. Convert this also in Kelvin. S superheated is equal to Sg plus 2.3 into log base 10 of the ratio T superheated divided by T saturated. V superheated is equal to Vg into T superheated divided by T saturated. So in this way we can find out the value of H, S, V for superheated steam. But remember one thing, in this formula temperature is in Kelvin. So to convert temperature in degree Celsius to Kelvin, what we have to do? 14 plus 273.15. Add this value, you will get in the value in Kelvin. Next is saturated water and steam pressure base table. It contains values of saturation temperature in degree Celsius, specific volume in meter cube per kg, specific enthalpy in kilojoule per kg and specific entropy in kilojoule per kg Kelvin from 0.0061 bar to 221.2 bar, that is critical pressure of water. This is table 2 pressure base because first column is of pressure. Second column gives us the value of saturation temperature in degree Celsius for the given pressure. Again, I am repeating, second column gives us the value of saturation temperature in degree Celsius for given pressure. Third column is having Vf, Vg. Fourth column is having Hf, Hfg, Hg. Fifth column is having Sf, Sfg, Hg, Sg. And last column, again, pressure. In this, we have taken an example and we have to find the specific volume, specific enthalpy, specific entropy of steam at an absolute pressure 0.060 bar when the dryness fraction, that is X, is 0.7. Note, as absolute pressure 0.060 bar is given, so we will use table 2, that is pressure table, because first column is pressure base. From steam table 2 at 0.060 bar, we get the value of T, saturation temperature, equal to 36.18 degree Celsius. So our pressure is 0.060 bar. So this is 0.060 bar. So at this pressure, the value of saturation temperature is 36.18. And at this pressure, we are having this value of Vf, then this value of Vg, then this value of Hf, this value of Hfg, this value of Hg, this value of Sf, this value of Sfg, this value of Sg. Now, as the drainage fraction is given as 0.7, so our steam is wet steam. So for wet steam, we are having the formula V equal to Vf plus X into Vfg. H equal to Hf plus X Hfg. S equal to Sf plus X Sfg. We have find out the value of Vf, Hf, Sf, Vfg, Hfg, Sfg from the steam table. Here there is no space between F and G. So we have already find out this value. Value of x is 0.7 and VFG is equal to VG minus VF. HFG is equal to HG minus HF. SFG is equal to SG minus SF. When the value of temperature 40 degrees Celsius and pressure 0.060 bar is given, then from table 2, we find out that at 0.06 bar, the value of saturation temperature is 36.18 degrees Celsius. So you can see at 0.06 bar, the value of saturation temperature is 36.18 degrees Celsius, which is lesser than 40 degrees Celsius. Therefore, at temperature 40 degrees Celsius and pressure 0.06 bar, water is in superheated vapor region, that is superheated steam. For superheated steam, we will use the below formula, and in this formula, find the value of Hg, Sg, Vg at 36.18 degrees Celsius and 0.060 bar from table 2. We have already find out these values. And CpV is the specific heat and constant pressure for vapor. So, for superheated steam, the value of H superheated will be equal to Hg plus CpV into T superheated minus T saturated. H superheated is equal to Sg plus 2.3 into log base 10 of the ratio T superheated divided by T saturated. This saturated is in subscript. So, change this. Then, V superheated is equal to Vg into ratio of T superheated divided by T saturated. Here, T superheated is 40 degrees Celsius and T saturated is 36.18 degrees Celsius. Convert this degree Celsius into Kelvin in this formula. To convert degree Celsius to Kelvin, what we have to do? We have to add 273.15 to this value, 36.18, and also to this value 40 plus 273.15 to convert degree Celsius into Kelvin. Next is superheated steam table. These tables contain the values of specific volume in meter cube per kg, specific enthalpy in kilojoule per kg, and specific entropy in kilojoule per kg Kelvin from an absolute pressure of 0.02 bar to 221.2 bar critical pressure at various temperature from 100 degrees Celsius to 800 degrees Celsius for the superheated vapor region. So these tables are meant only for superheated steam. This is table number 3, specific volume. So it gives us the value of specific volume of superheated steam. First column is of absolute pressure in bar. Second column gives us the value of saturation temperature corresponding to given pressure. And here we are having the value of specific volume for various temperature in degree Celsius, like at 100 degrees Celsius, 150, 200, 250, and so on. So we will find out the value of specific volume at these temperatures, and the condition is superheated steam. Table 4, specific enthalpy of superheated steam. So it gives us the value of specific enthalpy of superheated steam. It is similar to table 3. Only difference here, we are finding specific enthalpy value. First column, absolute pressure in bar. Second column, saturation temperature corresponding to given pressure. And here in the third column, we are finding the specific enthalpy in kilojoule per kg at various temperatures like 100, 150, 200, 250 in degree Celsius. Table 5, specific entropy of superheated steam. So through this table 5, we are able to find out the value of specific entropy of superheated steam. So table 5 is about specific entropy. First column is about absolute pressure in bar. Second column gives us the value of saturation temperature corresponding to given pressure. In the third column, specific entropy in kilojoule per kg Kelvin at various temperatures, that is 100, 150, 200, 250, 300 degree Celsius. We have taken an example in which we have to calculate the specific volume, specific enthalpy and specific entropy of steam at an pressure, absolute pressure 0.8 bar and temperature 150 degree Celsius. Note, at an absolute pressure 0.8 bar, the value of saturation temperature is 93.5 degree Celsius. You can see, at absolute pressure 0.8 bar, the value of saturation temperature in degree Celsius is 93.5, which is lesser than given temperature of 150 degree Celsius. That is, 150 degree Celsius is the temperature of superheated steam at pressure 0.8 bar. Therefore, we will use superheated steam table, because at given pressure and temperature, our steam is in superheated state. From superheated steam table 3, at 0.8 bar and 150 degree Celsius, 0.8 bar and at 150 degree Celsius, the value of specific entropy is 2.425 in meter cube per kg. From superheated steam table 4, at 0.8 bar and 150 degree Celsius, table 4, we are having pressure 0.8 bar and the given temperature is 150 degree Celsius. So, the value is 2777.8 in kilojoule per kg. This one. From superheated steam table 5, at 0.8 bar and 150 degree Celsius, the value of specific entropy 0.8 bar and 150 degree Celsius, the value of specific entropy is 7.720 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So, in this way, we have find out the value of V from table 3, value of H from table 4 and value of S from table 5 for the superheated steam. Four values that are not listed exactly in the tables, the value between two values can be obtained by linear interpolation. Interpolation is a mathematical tool by which, depending on the interval between two variables, a value in between can be calculated. For example, calculate the specific entropy of steam at an absolute pressure 0.8 bar and temperature 170 degree Celsius. So, here we are having 0.8 bar pressure and the temperature is 170. So, 170 lies between 150 and 200. So, we have to use interpolation. Note, at an absolute pressure 0.8 bar, the value of saturation temperature is 93.5 degrees Celsius. At 0.8 bar, the value of saturation temperature is 93.5 degrees Celsius, which is lesser than 170 degrees Celsius. That is, 170 degrees Celsius is the temperature of superheated steam at pressure 0.8 bar. Therefore, we will use the superheated steam table. From superheated steam table 5, because we have to find out the value of specific entropy, at 0.8 bar and temperature 150 degrees Celsius, the value of S1 is 7.720 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. This is 0.8 bar And at 150 degrees Celsius, the value of specific entropy is 7.720. And at pressure 0.8 bar, the value of temperature 200 degrees Celsius, this is T2. Change this, this is T2. And the entropy S2 is equal to 7.940 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. At pressure 0.8 bar, the value of temperature T2 is 200 degrees Celsius. So at this temperature T2 equal to 200 degrees Celsius, the value of entropy comes out to be 7.940. So at T2, 200 degrees Celsius, the value of S2 comes out to be 7.940 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So we will use the interpolation technique. So value of S at T equal to 170 degrees Celsius, because 170 degree lies between 150 and 200 degrees Celsius. The formula says S1 plus T minus T1, S2 minus S1, T2 minus T1 is equal to 7.720 plus 170 minus 150 into 7.940 minus 7.720 200 minus 150. Here T2 is 200, T1 is 150, S2 is 7.940, S1 is 7.720. Value of T is equal to, or the value of T given is 170 and the S1 is 7.720. In the similar manner, the values of specific volume, specific enthalpy and specific entropy at any other pressure or temperature not mentioned in the table from 1 to 5 is obtained by linear interpolation. Next is supercritical steam table. Supercritical means above critical point. These tables contain the values of specific volume in meter cube per kg, specific enthalpy in kilojoule per kg, specific entropy in kilojoule per kg Kelvin from an absolute pressure of 250 bar to 1000 bar at various temperature from 400 degrees Celsius to 800 degrees Celsius. In these tables also, the values of specific enthalpy, specific volume and specific entropy of steam are rightly read from the concerned table. However, the values of specific volume, specific enthalpy and specific entropy at any other pressure or temperature not mentioned in the table can be obtained by linear interpolation. Reference state and reference values. The values of specific internal energy, specific enthalpy and specific entropy cannot be measured directly, and they are calculated from measurable properties using the relation between thermodynamic properties. However, those relations give the changes in properties, not the values of properties at specified state. Therefore, we need to choose a convenient reference state and assign a value for a convenient property or properties at that state. For water, the state of saturated liquid at 0.01 degrees Celsius is taken as the reference state, and the internal energy and entropy are assigned zero values at that state. Different tables list different values for some properties at the same state as a result of using a different reference state. However, in thermodynamics, we are concerned with the changes in properties, and the reference state is of no consequence in calculation as long as we use values from single consistent set of tables or charts. Some properties may have negative values as a result of reference state 1000. As you can see, reference state is 0.01 degree Celsius. So we are saying at this reference state, the value of internal energy and entropy are assigned zero values at that state. You can see in table 1, you can see the value is 0. These are the references. Thanks. Any questions? You can write to me gaurav.citm@gmail.com.